Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we'll be taking a look at an app I've never talked about on this channel. It's called BBEdit. BBEdit is a text editor that's been around on the Mac for decades, and version 15 just came out with an interesting implementation of ChatGPT that I wanted to call out, show you how it works, because it's not totally clear at the start, and yeah, you can see if it's going to be interesting to you. I will say the pricing up front for BBEdit, it's a paid upfront app, there's no subscription pricing. It's $60 for the app if you've never owned it before. If you're upgrading from the previous version, version 14, it's $30. If you're upgrading from an earlier version of the app, it's $40. So let's jump into the demo. Okay, so we're here on the Mac and we've got a project open here with a bunch of files and everything. And my typical development workflow is to have the project open in Visual Studio Code, which is my favorite editor for code situations. And then I have ChatGPT open where I can ask it questions. How do I do this thing? Here's a function. Why isn't it working? That sort of thing. I find it really helpful as a companion while I'm doing my work. And if it gives me answers that are perfect, then awesome. If they're not perfect, I can test them and then I can iterate on them. And it typically gets me going in the right direction. I made a whole video showing how I used this to help me get over a hump with this actual project, actually. So here's the website. I'll put this in the description. It's mostly a website for me, but lets you write reviews for things, customize everything from the colors and everything, and then save it to your desktop or your computer, or your phone, whatever, and share that to social media as a review. Anyway, we're not talking about quick reviews today. We're talking about how I use ChatGPT in the development process. So let's get out of VS Code and let's get out of the browser and pull up BBEdit with that same project. So here's the same project pulled up. I can do all the same things. But their way of doing ChatGPT is a little different. So I'm gonna go into new, and I'm gonna do a new ChatGPT worksheet. And so we'll shrink this down a little, scoot it on over here. And you can see down here at the bottom, we're using GPT 3.5 Turbo. You can actually switch to whatever model you prefer. And you can start off by saying, hello there, oops. And how do you submit this to ChatGPT? It doesn't really make it clear how to do that, but it's control return. And the first time you do this, it's going to prompt you to provide your ChatGPT API key. So you can click this link to log in. I'm actually already logged in. So basically, once you're in, you're going to go to the API keys page. You're going to create a new secret key. We're going to call it BBEdit video, which I'm going to delete right after I record this. And then you can copy this to your clipboard. Cool. And let's go back over to, or actually done here. Let's go back to BBEdit, paste this in and continue. And so there we go. So it responded. What color is the sky? All right, so these are kind of just not interesting questions, but I could say, let's go into my code and say, I want to do something where someone posts data to this, right? So I'm gonna say, how do I write a PHP function that accepts posted data from the user? Submit, and then this is gonna take a couple seconds. One thing I don't like is that there's not a clear indication that it's working, and it doesn't type out the text as the response comes in. You'll just see kind of a spinner here next to whatever model you've selected. It's a little nicer on the website, so if I, there's actually the whole answer here, but if I kind of pull this up on ChatGPT's web interface, the exact same question, this is ChatGPT 4, so it's gonna be a little slower, but what I like is being able to see it print out the answer as it goes. It's actually a lot slower in this case. Wow, really a lot slower. Let's change to 3.5 just to make it quicker for the video. So here we are, and it puts it in a code block and everything. You can copy the code block. So there's definitely some advantages to using the web interface still, and I think that's probably how I'll continue using it. But I did think it was interesting that you can kind of see it here and you can kind of expand to make it a little wider. But here's the function. Here's an example function. It walks you through it. And then I can go ahead and delete this and kind of start over. But it actually remembers your conversation history. So let's save this file. We're gonna save it to the desktop. So we're not gonna rename it or anything, but we're just gonna name it up here. And you can see it's empty in BBEdit. But if I open it with, let's do Nova, which is another text editor. Let's open it in Nova. And you can see there's actually this whole dictionary here with the questions that have happened before, the answers that it gave, and those are context for what it has here. So you actually don't lose that history when you delete this text from here, so you can actually clean up your workspace and keep talking, and it remembers the context. What did we just talk about? So I'll prove that kind of here. We just discussed how to write a PHP function that accepts data. If I save this, you're actually going to see the file update with, like, here's the text. And anyway, that's a minor detail. It's interesting, I thought. But basically, whenever you save these documents and kind of just delete them, it still retains that conversation history, so you can pull back on that and ChatGPT understands where you are. And what I think you would typically do is kind of save this to your project folder so that you can just have this as an ongoing chat with ChatGPT. You can change the model, so we can go to ChatGPT-4. And if we go into BBEdit's preferences, there is a ChatGPT worksheets page where you can change the default model. So let's set it to GPT-4 by default. You can tell it when to wrap lines in the response. And if you want to clear your API key for whatever reason, you can go ahead and do that as well. The last thing I'll show you today is on this page. If we go into our usage metrics, this is where you're going to see what ChatGPT is going to bill you for what you've done. So I've been using this just a little bit last night and right now during this video, and I've actually spent 61 cents doing this. You can actually see how much more expensive ChatGPT. I've spent 61 cents. I spent less than a penny on GPT 3.5. So if you want to use this for as cheap as possible, use GPT 3.5 and only use GPT 4 if you need to. I actually have a limit, so if I hit 20 bucks, it'll cut me off during this month to make sure that I don't go crazy and spend, empty my bank account, accidentally sending GPT things. But yeah, so this is where you're going to get billed. This isn't through BBEdit or anything. This is completely through ChatGPT. But yeah, just a thing to note. Very, very cheap if you're using 3.5, but yeah, that's where it's going to happen there. And yeah, kind of an interesting thing. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.